So hi everyone and welcome back once again to the session of government schemes. In today's session I will bring to you another very important scheme jiska naam hai PM Daksh Yojana. Ye scheme guys recently launched hui thi in the previous financial year. This was launched in the previous financial year 2020-21 by the Ministry of Social Justice and Empowerment. And I hope mujhe aapko batane ki zarurat nahi padni chahiye that this scheme is very relevant for the upcoming exam of NABARD. Because recently it was in news also because PM Daksh portal and PM Daksh app was also launched. So let's begin with the session and kal ka session nahi ho paya tha due to some reason. Aaj hai, Monday hoga aur aage bhi continue rahega, don't worry. But before we begin, do subscribe to the channel and press this bell icon. You can also join this Telegram group. Here you will get the PDF of this session and also you can ask any doubt here. And if you want to have a personal connect with me, you can follow me here. This is my Instagram ID. So let's talk about the scheme and let's first of all do those things that you can do effortlessly jinko aapko dobara se padhne ki zarurat nahi padegi. So first of all let's try to simplify the objective of this particular scheme. Iske objective ki baat karte hain. Objective dekho iske naam mein clear hai. What is the full form of this scheme? Pradhan Mantri Dakshata aur Kushalta Sampann Hitgrahi. Pradhan Mantri Dakshata aur Kushalta Sampann Hitgrahi. I know जिनको हिंदी नहीं आती उनके लिए काफी डिफिकल्ट हो जाएगा बट डोंट वरी इनका इंग्लिश मीनिंग मैं आपको बता दूंगा. प्रधानमंत्री दक्षता और कुशलता संपन्न हितग्राही. नाउ व्हाट इज द मीनिंग ऑफ दक्षता. दक्षता मींस एफिशिएंसी. कुशलता मींस व्हाट? स्किल्ड. एंड ऑफ कोर्स संपन्न मींस व्हाट? फुल ऑफ और यू कैन से कंप्लीट. एंड हितग्राही का मतलब होता है बेनिफिशियरी. व्हाट इज द मीनिंग ऑफ हितग्राही? बेनिफिशियरी. सो बेनिफिशियरी who is efficient and skilled. ये इस पूरे स्कीम का मतलब है. A beneficiary who is efficient and skilled. Alright. So अब यहाँ से हमें ये चीज क्लियर हो जाती है that this scheme is for the skill development. Alright. This is for what? Skill development. Because यहाँ पे क्या किसकी बात हो रही है? Skill की बात हो रही है. ठीक है. Which means that this scheme is for the skill development. But the question is, ये skill development किसकी होगी? ठीक है. किसके लिए होगी? कौन इसके बेनिफिशियरीज होंगे? हु विल बी द बेनिफिशियरी ऑफ दिस पर्टिकुलर स्कीम? ऑफ हुम द स्किल्स विल बी डेवलप? किनके लिए ये स्किल डेवलपमेंट स्कीम है? सो लेट मी टेल यू दिस. दिस इज फॉर शेड्यूल कास्ट. दिस इज फॉर ओबीसीज. दिस इज फॉर इकोनॉमिकली वीकर सेक्शंस और इकोनॉमिकली वीकर क्लास. देन इट इज फॉर डीएनटीज. व्हाट इज दिस डीएनटीज? डीएनटी स्टैंड्स फॉर डी नोटिफाइड नोमैडिक एंड सेमी नोमैडिक ट्राइब्स. ऑलराइट. Denotified nomadics and semi-nomadic tribes and of course safai karmchari. In sabhi logon ke liye scheme hai and this is a skill development scheme. This is basically a skill development plan for all these people, all these category of people. Okay. So I hope guys the objective is clear. Objective iska bahut clear hai. Objective iska clear ye hai ki iski जो बेसिक ऑब्जेक्टिव है दैट इज स्किल डेवलपमेंट. ठीक है. इसका ऑब्जेक्टिव क्या है? स्किल डेवलपमेंट है जिसमें किन किसकी स्किल डेवलपमेंट की जाएगी? इन इन कैटेगरी के लोगों की. और इनका याद इनका जो कैटेगरी है वो याद रखना. इसके अलावा और कोई कैटेगरी नहीं है. देर इज नो अदर कैटेगरी अदर देन दिस. एस सीज ओ बी सीज ई डब्ल्यू सीज डी एन टीज एंड सफाई कर्मचारी. एंड डू रिमेंबर द फुल फॉर्म ऑफ डी एन टी. डी नोटिफाइड नोमैडिक एंड सेमी नोमैडिक ट्राइब्स. ऑलराइट. सो आई होप द ऑब्जेक्टिव इज क्लियर. एंड remember the government has the target that they will provide skill, they will develop the skills of around 2.7 lakh persons over a period of 5 years. And this year, for this financial year 2021-22, they have a target that they will develop the skills of around 50,000 people. ठीक है. और ये जितने भी beneficiary अभी हमने देखे उनमें से category भी है that out of the targeted groups these people will be मोर फोकस्ड. इनके ऊपर ज्यादा फोकस होगा. आर्टिसंस के ऊपर, विमेन के ऊपर एंड यूथ के ऊपर. ओके. अमंग द एस सीज, अमंग द ओबीसीज, ईबीसीज, डीएनटीज एंड सफाई कर्मचारी द फोकस विल बी ऑन द आर्टिसंस, विमेन एंड यूथ फ्रॉम द टारगेटेड ग्रुप. ऑलराइट. और ये ऑब्जेक्टिव मैंने लिख दिया है तो आप ये देख लेना. ऑफकोर्स द मिनिस्ट्रीज, मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ सोशल जस्टिस एंड एम्पावरमेंट विच इज हेडेड बाय डॉक्टर वीरेंद्र कुमार. हिज लोकसभा कॉन्स्टिट्यूएंसी इज टीकमगढ़. लोकसभा कॉन्स्टिट्यूएंसी याद रखना वीरेंद्र कुमार की टीकमगढ़ है. Now let's talk about the types of skilling program which are being provided under this particular scheme. So remember there are 4 types of program. Okay, number 1 is the upskilling or reskilling. This program is for those, this component of training is for those who are already skilled, who have some basic skills, and through this program the skills of these people will enhance. Okay. Upskilling mein kya hoga? Jo already skilled people hai, like artisans hai, weavers hai, farmers hai, सफाई कर्मचारी हैं, डोमेस्टिक वर्कर्स हैं, दे विल बी प्रोवाइडेड ट्रेनिंग फॉर एनहांसमेंट ऑफ देयर स्किल. द टोटल ड्यूरेशन ऑफ दिस प्रोग्राम विल बी 32 to 80 hours, एंड जो भी कॉस्ट होगी ट्रेनिंग कॉस्ट की, दैट विल बी बियर बाय द गवर्नमेंट बिकॉज इट इज अ सेंट्रल सेक्टर स्कीम. It is a central sector scheme, so 100% grant will be provided by the central government. All right. Second program is the short-term training. Second type of training is what? Short-term training. This means short-term trainings will be provided, jiski duration hogi normally 200 hours to 600 hours and up to maximum 6 months, and it will be focused on the employment. Okay. Moving ahead to another component, another part of training, that is entrepreneurship development. So those SCs and OBC youth जिनके अंदर entrepreneurship का एक जो कि entrepreneurship की तरफ bent है अपनी life में, जो कि चाहते हैं जिन्होंने जो कि चाहते हैं entrepreneur बनना, and those who have acquired the skills through the प्रधानमंत्री कौशल विकास योजना, this is for those. And for these type of people, the entrepreneurship development training will be provided. How? Like some kind of business opportunity guidance will be provided, market survey mein help hogi, working capital management, business plan preparation, etc. So these type of help will be provided, these type of training will be provided under this particular component. And also duration is 80 to 90 hours. Duration iska kitna hai? 80 to 90 hours. And number 4 is the long term training. Of course this component is for providing long term training, और जिसका ड्यूरेशन होगा 5 महीने से लेके 1 साल तक का है. द ड्यूरेशन ऑफ दिस कॉम्पोनेंट, द ड्यूरेशन ऑफ दिस टाइप ऑफ ट्रेनिंग इज मिनिमम 5 months टू मैक्सिमम 1 year, एंड ऑफ कोर्स द ट्रेनिंग विल बी प्रोवाइडेड इन दो सेक्टर जिसमें जॉब की डिमांड है. ओके नाउ अब इसमें यह है कि आफ्टर कंप्लीशन ऑफ द ट्रेनिंग, अब ट्रेनिंग कंप्लीट हो गई, आफ्टर कंप्लीशन ऑफ द ट्रेनिंग इफ अ ट्रेनिंग वॉन्ट्स टू डू हिज ओन वर्क, इफ ही वॉन्ट्स टू सेट अप हिज ओन एंटरप्राइज, देन इन दैट केस he can also avail loan from substitutes of the Ministry of Social Justice and Empowerment. Like for example, SCs, scheduled caste people can have loan from the National Scheduled Caste Finance Development Corporation. OBCs can have their loan from National Backward Classes Finance and Development Corporation. And Safai Karamcharis can have their loan from National Safai Karamchari Finance and Development Corporation. And all these three bodies are the substitute of, are the part of all these work under the Ministry of Social Justice and Empowerment. Do remember this. And now let's move ahead to the things, guys, that you have to remember. First of all, you have to remember that the scheme was launched in the year 2020-21, the previous financial year, and this is the eligibility that you have to remember. First of all, remember the training will be provided to only those who are between this age group 18 to 45, and also ये क्या है टारगेट ग्रुप और उनकी एलिजिबिलिटी. नंबर वन, ऑल दी एससीज, देयर इज नो इनकम सीलिंग इनकम क्राइटेरिया फॉर दी एससी कैंडिडेट, व्हाइल देयर इज एन इनकम क्राइटेरिया फॉर ओबीसीज एंड ईबीसीज. ओबीसीज के लिए क्या है, हैविंग एनुअल इनकम बिलो ₹3 lakh. फॉर ईबीसीज इट इज ₹1 lakh. द इफ द कैंडिडेट इज एन ईबीसी, इकोनॉमिकली बैकवर्ड क्लास, इज फ्रॉम द ईबीसी, देन द एनुअल फैमिली इनकम शुड बी बिलो ₹1 lakh. Then denotified nomadic and semi-nomadic tribe, there is no income ceiling. And also then safai karamcharis and their dependents, there is no income ceiling. So ye main aapko pehle bata chuka hu, here you just have to remember this income ceiling and also this age group 18 to 45 years. And for OBCs, the annual family income should be less than 3 lakh, while for the EBC it should be less than ₹1 lakh. All right. And now these are some of the other key features, like training is absolutely free of cost for the trainees, and for that 100% amount is provided by the central government. Stipend of ₹1,000 to ₹1,500 per month per trainee, and only those trainees who have attendance 80% or more. Wage compensation at ₹3,000 per trainee, and it will be bifurcated into two parts, 25 as per the PM Daksh and ₹2,500 as per the PM Daksh and 500 as per the common cost norms for training having 80% or more attendance. Okay, so these are some of the other features, and we all know recently PM Daksh portal and PM Daksh mobile app was launched by the Minister of Social Justice and Empowerment, jiski wajah se jo process hai enrollment ka wo kafi easy ho jayega. And in this year's union budget, ₹100 crore has been allocated to this particular scheme. Okay, so I hope guys the scheme is clear. एक बार जल्दी से दोबारा से देख लेते हैं, इतना ही पढ़ना है, इसमें से ज्यादा पढ़ने की जरूरत नहीं है. So what is the objective of this scheme? Objective of the scheme is the skill development, because naam mein hi hai iske kya kya, dakshata means efficiency, kushalta means skilled, and sampanna means complete or full of. So a beneficiary who is full of, who is efficient and who is skilled is the meaning of this scheme, which means the scheme is for skill development. And who are the beneficiaries? These are SCs, OBCs, EBCs, economically backward classes, DNTs, denotified, nomadic and semi-nomadic tribes, and also Safai Karamcharis and their dependents. This is the target. The government has the target to develop the skills of 2.7 lakh persons in the upcoming 5 years. And for this financial year, the target is 50,000 persons. And of course, within the targeted group, the focus will be on the artisans, women and the youth. Okay. It is being implemented by the Ministry of Social Justice and Empowerment. Of course, these are four types of training program under this particular scheme. Number one is upskilling or reskilling. Number two, short-term training. Number three is the entrepreneurship development. And number four is the long-term training. Okay. And after completion of the training, the beneficiary can also have loan for setting up his or her own enterprise from the organizations of Ministry of Social Justice and Empowerment, like these three. And it was launched in the previous financial year 2021, and this is the eligibility criteria. These are some of the other key features. And recently PM Daksh portal and PM Daksh mobile app was launched, and this year's union budget has allocated rupees 100 crore to this particular scheme. So I hope guys the scheme is clear. And now let's talk about the questions that can be asked. Which of the following is not one of the trainings provided under PM Daksh scheme? So PM Daksh scheme mein kaun si training nahi provide hoti? Short term trainings is there, long term trainings is there, entrepreneurship development, reskilling or upskilling. Incubation training is not there. Incubation training guys is not there. Option E will be the correct answer. Question number 2. Which of the following statements is incorrect with respect to the PM Daksh scheme? Incorrect statement batana. The scheme is being implemented by the Ministry of Skill Development. So yahi pehla hi statement galat ho gaya. Please don't get confused. Dekho yahan pe confusion ho sakti hai. You can have confusion here because the scheme is about the skill development. So you can get confused between the Ministry of Skill Development and Social Justice and Empowerment. So you have to keep in mind that this scheme is being implemented by Social Justice and Empowerment Ministry. So yahi hamara sahi jawab ho jayega. Option A is the correct answer to this question. Okay. And that's it for the session guys. I hope the scheme is clear and all the questions are clear. So aaj Friday hai, to agla session jo hoga Monday ko hoga. In the meantime, you have to revise all the schemes. Saturday Sunday ko time hai aapke paas. Scheme ka revise kar, jitni bhi schemes humne padhi unki revision kar lena. Thank you so much for watching. Milte hain Monday ke session mein. Goodbye, take care and God bless.